Yo. Welcome to another week of Pedis and Mimosas. I am your girl, DJ Westby. So look, I need y'all to make some noise right now for the hostess with the mostest, Miss Shady Mac. Okay, here you go.
Such a New Yorker, Jesus. Hi, everybody. How y'all feeling? Hey, Pedis and Mimosas live. We are here. Guess what?
Why?
It's my birthday.
That's why you have your quinceañera dress on?
Yes, I got my quinceañera.
Oh, my God, you got to do it. Do it. Shimmy, shimmy, shimmy. You got to hit the shimmy in it. Yeah.
Silly. So silly.
How you feeling?
I feel old. I'm just messing.
Do you feel accomplished?
I do.
Do you feel like, okay, this was the goal, but I feel like I met it and I'm above that or no?
I don't even think like that anymore. I'm just letting God move me.
Okay.
It is what it is.
Okay, I like that.
Yeah. I feel proud of myself every day, though. Birthday or not.
Hit it.
I'm letting God use me the way he wants to use me. Use me, God, use me.
Me and Miss Rich, you ready? You ready for the song we gonna do?
Oh, let's do it.
Okay, look, I need everybody in the crowd to participate, right? Because it's the birthdays, girl, birthday. So we gotta do some real special stuff, okay? We gonna do the Stevie Wonder version. And if y'all know what I'm talking about the happy birthday song. Do y'all all know that out there? Yeah. Okay, so y'all ready? So I'm gonna say 1, 2, 3, and then we gonna go. Y'all ready?
Let's do it.
1, 2, 3, let's go.
Happy birthday to you.
What?
Happy birthday to you.
Go.
Happy birthday.
Rock.
Happy birthday to you.
Oh, what? Where was you? Was you drinking in the back? Was you drinking in the back?
I
you
appreciate was okay. The birthday love.
I drink in the back, I drink in the front.
Okay.
I drink on the sides.
I appreciate the birthday love.
We tried.
But I'm happy to be here. No, all jokes aside, last year we had COVID.
Oh God, don't remind me.
We left it back in 2021, but that gave me a whole new perspective on life. Because it wasn't easy. So I'm glad to be here. Because it could have been any way. Anything could have happened. Hey. Some people didn't make it.
Hey.
You know?
We could have been on ventilators.
Anything.
I'm just saying.
So I'm happy to see another birthday. Always. Thank you, boy. Thank you. Hi, Rich.
Hey.
Y'all say what's up to my bartender.
What's up, y'all?
How you feel today?
Oh, I feel good. How you feel, birthday girl?
It's my birthday.
Oh, yeah.
I feel good.
That's good.
But I'm going to feel even better when you make me a Junipero Gin Mimosa.
Ooh, I got you.
That's what I want today. You got me?
We got you.
You got my back like bra straps?
I got your back, front, side. You name it, I got it.
Cool. So, you know we toasting to survival.
Yes, we are.
Yes, we having great, impactful conversation with all our guests.
As we should.
And I have a funny guest here today.
Do you really?
A legend.
Okay.
In the building.
Okay.
I ain't even going to say his name. I'm tired of waiting to bring my guest out. So, y'all want to keep it locked. It's Pedis Mimosas Live. Give it up!
Whoa.
Pedis and Mimosas Live, and I'm not even going to waste another minute. He's amazing, he's funny, he's been in the game for a minute, and he's a cool friend of mine. Y'all give it up for Miguel Nuñez!
Hey! 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 Wait. Cut! Listen, I heard it's your birthday, right?
Yeah.
I got something for you.
What you got for me?
Oh, don't get excited. It's just a drink.
I'm like,
like, just wait. A little drink. It's a little Jello. Jello shot.
Slurp shot.
There you go.
We're going to take one together.
I just want to see how excited you got. That's all.
I'm like, wait.
So wait, what I got to do?
Are we rolling?
What I got to do? I really got to take
my feet off? I want to see your toes, Miguel.
Oh, no. You didn't tell me I had to do this. Everybody got to sign a non-disclosure.
Yep. They do. They did.
I really do have to show you my feet.
You don't want to get a pedicure? It's Pedis and Mimosas.
No, I do, but do you have to show them before?
Oh, like, no.
Can you just
no,
show
no,
the
no.
after?
No. I wouldn't do
okay,
that.
Okay, look.
To you.
My feet are bad. Look.
That's pure.
If Shaq can show his feet, I can show mine.
For real. That's pure, unadulterated ugliness.
Did you see Shaq's feet? No, look, I like Shaq, and I'm sure everybody loves Shaq. Shaq's one of the greatest.
His feet look
one
terrible.
One of the greatest. His feet look like cadavers. No, you think I'm joking. Look online, Google it. His feet literally look like a cadaver foot. But he knows it.
Yeah, he makes fun of it a lot.
He's not embarrassed about it.
He ain't the only one. You seen Oprah's feet?
God. Oh, my. Oprah's toe looked like she throwing up gang signs.
God. Damn, Oprah. All that money, you can't fix the feet.
Well, listen, when you got my Oprah money, Oprah like, shit, I got billions. I don't give a damn right. what my toe look
I think
like.
Oprah got six toes
If you worried about my
foot.
Toe, bye, nigga.
You know, I think she got six toes on one foot.
I heard she did. I think she got one removed, right?
I don't think so.
I thought Stedman went. No, I'm kidding. I'm just totally kidding. No, I didn't hear that. I thought that was a joke.
I seen a picture of it. I think she got an extra pinky.
Really?
She got a better grip on the ground.
It's
cool.
See, nobody else is going to go with you on that.
No, seriously. I think
hey, so. DJ. What DJ is she got? How many toes she got?
How many toes who got?
Oprah.
Oh, I don't know. I mean,
wait on. You know she had bionic ankles?
Yo,
no,
cannot.
That's true.
How?
That's very true.
Why?
I was talking to her backstage. Tell them about your bionic ankles.
Yeah, so I was actually in a car accident 2019, mm-hmm. and I broke both of my ankles. So for the replacement, they put metal screws and rods and plates in them. So yes, I do have bionic ankles. I do.
So if you kick somebody in the ass, would it hurt worse?
It might.
Do you go off when you go through the metal detectors or the alarm at the
that's
airport?
A good answer.
Yeah, I actually, you know what's funny? Is after I got them, I went through the metal detector just to see them go off.
Did it?
Yes, they went off.
You have to explain that every time?
Yes, every time.
It's my ankles.
It's the ankles. They be like, what? And they got to ring it and they be going all the way down. And they get down. They're like, ding, ding, ding. I'm like, I told you.
Wow.
Just like I just discovered, don't wear a waist trainer through them things neither. It set me off twice.
What is a waist trainer?
Listen. One of them things that train your waist and get you cinched in and just...
Oh, why? Isn't it made out of cloth?
Because some of us just are not blessed with flat stomachs like yours. So we got to train it.
And I eat 3 tons of food. If I eat 3 tons of food, I'll lose 10 pounds.
Really?
I remember when I was little... Come on, baby, keep my foot out of camera.
It's not.
Don't worry, you're not. We got you, Miguel.
And can you do it like, you know what, you're using, let me see what you're using. This is what you clip the nails with? Well, when I go to my lady, she likes to bite them. Can you do that for me?
I didn't pay me enough to do that.
But wait, if the price was right.
She'd be like, okay.
Y'all should have seen the thing she said.
Y'all gonna call me over.
Isn't that good?
I cannot. Miguel, you lick toes?
Do I lick toes? Mm-hmm. Hell no, who would lick a toe?
You seem like the type that lick toes.
No, I sucked my ex-girlfriend's toe once, but that's because she was clean and we was in the tub together. And
so
all
you
that.
Have to be in a setting like that in order to go in on the toes?
Listen to me. Just tell me this. Look at this and tell me how. Where is this sexy anywhere?
I agree.
Somebody's toe. How do you make licking a toe sexy?
Yeah, that's gross.
How do you make that sexy? I can't do it. Yeah, I'd rather kiss you on your fine booty.
You like booties?
I like a fine ass. I'm not even really a breast man. I'm just, if it's a booty, I don't care if she got no breast.
But breast, it's like a booty on a chest.
Yeah, but I mean.
It's the same thing.
Yeah, but get in the way.
So if a girl is flat chested.
Doesn't matter.
But got a big booty, you're good.
Yes.
If she got big boobs and a big booty, you're good.
Better than good. Good, good.
If she got, if her booty's on her chest, but she don't got no booty.
Gotta go.
Really?
You gotta have an ass. I don't care if you could be the queen of, the most beautiful, stunning woman where she walked down the street, everybody look at her and the sun follow her and it gets cloudy everywhere else. It doesn't matter. If you turn to the side, I don't see no ass.
Oh, really?
Yes.
But what if she's your person?
What do you mean, my person?
Like, that you're supposed to marry and be together with forever.
But how would I know that if she repulses me?
Wow. You're a little shallow,
Miguel. No. Hold on, stop. Slow down. Oh, no, baby, slow down. I'm just kidding. No, that was just a deflection.
I cannot with you. Y'all give it up for Miguel. I cannot. Miguel, we got to order drinks. What you drinking?
Shit, I don't think I need another one, do you?
Get your menu.
Hey, where my man at?
We man at?
Where my dude at? The dude hooking me up with all the... Hey, right there. Matter of fact, what is your damn name?
Cause, you know,
Corey. That's my brother named
Corey. Shout out to
Corey. Corey, you know what I want? It's in the back. My two little cups.
What you drinking in the bag? No, we got special drinks for you right here.
Oh, shit. Well, you got it right here.
Yes, we got a whole bartender.
Hey, wait a minute. Who did this set?
Me.
I swear to you, I'm not joking right now. All jokes aside, this set is absolutely phenomenal.
And I
truly mean it. I've done a lot of things, and this is absolutely, absolutely a really stunning set.
Thank you. I worked with a set designer. And I mean, I ain't make it, but it's my vision.
It's your vision.
Yes,
yeah. Absolutely. But it looks good. Are those peanuts and stuff real?
Yes, funky chunky. You need some of that too.
You know I do. You got these sponsors. I want one of everything.
I think, you know what I think you was drinking? I think you had a shot of Junipero Gin. That's what I think.
That's exactly what I had.
Yes, so we got to do a shot of Junipero Gin.
I'll take it. There you go.
Yes.
There you go. Junipero Gin.
And I think you made with some.
What you drinking? No, baby, you don't drink, because when you bite my toes, you might bite too early.
I cannot.
Are they bad?
No.
You seen worse?
I've seen worse.
Is this your first pedicure?
No, I get them, but I got somebody I trust. She's a little Filipino girl I've been going to about 30 years. She know how to keep her mouth and her eyes closed.
Miguel, you look a little, I can't. I just picked that up. I just got that. You a mess. I love your energy, though. It was just what I needed on my birthday.
Oh, I'm so happy it's your birthday. And we are here still. God bless you.
Thank you.
You're 30?
32.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. A good man would never ask a girl about what her age. She never should ask her. Age is nothing but a number. Ever.
Age ain't nothing.
I'm old enough to be everybody on this entire set's grandfather.
You got grandkids?
No, I'm just saying, I'm old enough to be everybody here grandfather. And most of everybody in here probably wasn't even born.
Miguel, you've been in the game for a minute.
I am 63.
No!
Whoa.
Yeah. No,
fuck yes.
Not.
You're a damn liar.
How?
And I can run 1,000 miles, play 100 games of basketball. I don't need Viagra. It's 24/7. I got abs 24/7. I haven't worked out. I eat anything I want, and I never get tired.
Y'all give it up. So whatever you're doing, you gotta keep doing it.
Yep.
That, I did not think that you were 63, but really, what's 63?
I always get that. Some lady, I win so much money. This man, I was in Vegas, and I, you know how when somebody mess up on the blackjack table, and then the guy goes, and I'm in that one. He messed up the whole table because he shouldn't have took a card, and the dealer would have bust, and everybody would have been paid. I'm in the elevator going, fuck. This is on cable TV.
YouTube.
Oh, good. And then this guy goes, hey, listen to me, young man. I'm 47 years old. If you want to live to be my age, you're going to have to learn to let that stuff go.
Wow.
I want to be a daddy.
Yeah. Wow. Well, you look damn good.
It's all up to you. It's 100% up to you.
Yeah.
I can't explain it because we don't have enough time, but I promise you, I can show you exactly how to do it.
Dope.
Exactly how to turn the clock back. Exactly how to keep it where it is. Your internal clock does not have a watch on.
Right.
Okay, so imagine this. Imagine if there's this one little guy sitting right here, and there's three buttons above him, on and off. And then a big sign above it says, young. There's the same guy on this side with three buttons on and off, and above it says old. And I give you an example. My brother's like 10 years younger than me. And he walk around like this. Hold on, baby. You wanna get there like that? And he's slow and he acts like that. So when he comes to stay with me, I'm always hiding in the closet and scared as shit out of him. And the first thing he'd be like, "What the fuck wrong with you? What's wrong with you? How old are you?" So now we go inside to your internal clock.
Yeah.
Now the supervisor inside of the internal clock division, he hears this shit. He goes, whoa, what's going on? He asks this guy and this guy. The old and the young. He said, well, he just jumped out of the closet. Okay, so wait, stop. Who jumped out of the closet? Miguel. Young, old. Oh, so, okay, wait. How old is he? Is that something that a young person do or an old person do? I'm asking you.
Young.
Thank you. So now he's going to go over here and the young's going to turn that button on. The old folk but over this side going to turn the button off. Is it laughing and joking and like I do every single time, the energy, I can run, play, I play basketball on the court and jump on there every time. Is that something that a 60-something year man do or a young person do?
Young.
So now he's going to turn that other button off and then he's going to turn that over here on.
Right.
And it's saying your internal clock depends on you.
Right.
You. Yeah, they ain't got no, okay, hold it, and the birthday that hold it. They don't know none of that. They don't know that.
I feel you.
So mine's all my old, y'all shit is all my old shit is turned off, and I'm gonna keep it off until I'm ready for it to go on. So period.
I feel it. I like you.
Yeah, it's real.
So we're gonna order drinks. We're gonna get you your Junipero Gin shots.
Yeah, we're gonna get you a long time. Y'all bartender, sorry.
We'll be right back, y'all. Give it up for Miguel Nuñez. Mimosas Live. I'm your host, Shannon Mack. Please be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel right here, Shannon Mack TV. Follow me on Instagram. I am Shannon Mack. Follow our DJ, DJ West B. We have Miguel. Miguel, what's your IG handle?
M. Nuñez Jr. M-N-U-N-E-Z.
Follow.
And if you're from Europe, M-N-U-N-E-Z.
What's your IG?
WillSing920.
Follow.
So and what's your IG, baby? Foot.
Be Michelle Beauty.
Oh, and what's your IG?
Alaji. A-L-A-J-I.
And what's your IG? DJ Funk Master Love.
Funk Master Love. So
you have beautiful feet too.
Thank you. You wanna suck my toes?
Huh?
I'm just kidding.
I would.
Because
they clean. Because they all clean. But you gotta be laying back in the bed. You gotta be right sitting.
It's been a while for a sister that I'm just messing.
It has?
Well, let's define a while.
Okay, no, you tell.
Maybe my a while might be different from
your a while. Well, let's hear what your while is and I'll be the judge.
3 months.
That's a while.
That is. Oh. For my black ass, it is.
Really?
What's a while for you?
What's a while for me? Six, 8 months.
Yeah. What's been the longest?
For me?
Yeah.
8 months me after too. I got divorced.
Divorce. Yeah. How old were you when you got divorced?
God, I don't even remember. I swear to God, I literally don't know how. Everybody asks me, I don't know how old was when I did anything. I have to go and look at shit and read it because I literally don't keep up with it. It doesn't even confuse.
I always wonder.
My shit go and come and I don't know because I want to get lost in it. I have to literally look at my shit sometime to find out.
Wow. I always wonder what divorce is like for men. Ooh, I feel like they never talk about
baby.
That.
That's a bunion. That ain't a potato and shit. Yeah, do my face. Hey, stay right there. Right there. Yeah. She like, she peeling a motherfucking potato. Ow!
Wait, hold
stay
on.
Off the toe, honey.
Wait, did we order drinks? Because I don't think we did. We ordered Junipero Gin shots, yes.
Yes.
But I don't think we ordered drinks. So look at your menus.
Oh, wow.
Let's order a drink. I'm going to do a Soleil Mimosa.
Who and what or where? Oh, Soleil Mimosa. What does that mean?
It's a ready-to-drink mimosa that is amazing. You ain't got to mix it with nothing.
I'll
nothing.
Try that, too. Yes. You know what? I'll have my shot, and I'll have that drink as my chaser.
Yes. Gotcha. Yeah. I like it.
And if I get too drunk to go home, she bite them toes.
Listen. I might be drunk right there with you.
Energy Boost Virgin Minnesota. Oh.
No, yes, we got to cater to everybody. So we have some virgin non-alcoholic options there as well as alcoholic options. I think you need a virgin mimosa today.
What? What?
And you don't need one because you're working that toe too hard.
What you drinking, Elijah?
Are you ordering the virgin? You got the virgin?
Oh, you want to drink?
You take the virgin, okay?
I'll do the Schlumberger, the classic mimosa.
Schlumberger? This ain't food. We're talking about drinks.
Schlumberger is...
Schlumberger sparkling wine. Oh. I'm going to send you home with a bottle.
Okay, good.
Yes, I'm going to hook you up.
All right, good.
I'm going to hook you
up. And some of those little shot things. What are those?
Slurp shots.
Is it like...
Jello shots, but it's a slurp. It's called slurp shots.
That's a good idea. I like to get a lot of those from my fridge.
Yep.
I'm going to order some of those.
I'm going to hook you up.
Really?
I'm going to get you lit. You might need an Uber later.
Shit, I just stay at your house.
You can.
You said you ain't, how long? 3 months? Shit. 3 months? Yeah. You be waking here talking tomorrow. You be like, welcome to the show number 3. I'd like to introduce y'all to the executive producer, Miguel Nuñez.
But wait, I want to rewind a little bit back to divorce.
Oh, yes. Go
so,
ahead.
Yeah.
Why?
I feel like, no, because I feel like we always talk about like how divorce affects women, but we don't talk about how it affects
and
men.
It affects men the exact same way. I have 3 or 4 friends, some top name. I'm not even going to bring their names into it. A-list celebrities. And big friends, regular friends. Every man, it affects them the exact same way. I know at least 3 people sane and like me. I don't give up about nothing. I literally considered suicide.
Wow.
I know 3 other guys literally considered it as well. It is exactly as devastating to a man as it is to a woman.
Really?
Absolutely.
How long were you married?
15 years.
So here's the thing that I don't understand, and I get it. Sometimes you grow out of love or you grow apart, but after you're together for that long and
we're best
divorced,
friends now, so.
That's interesting. So what happened?
What happened what?
Why'd you get a divorce?
Well, I was on the road doing a play, and she had a baby, and so that's the most I can say.
And who baby was it?
It wasn't mine.
I'm sorry.
It is no sorry. I mean, it happened what it happened. I was on the road for 6 months doing a play, got off that road, did another 6 months, then got off that play and did another 6 months. Maybe I neglected where I should have been.
Oh, no.
And I should have
You blame yourself for that?
Well, I mean, I really wasn't there when I should have been, when my kids were like babies and she was there by herself.
Yeah.
So I don't negate what she said. Yeah. I don't negate her feelings and say, hey, well, ain't got nothing to do with it. You know, and if somebody came in, because I know if you had a problem with your man and you was married and he was on the road for 6 and then another 6 and another 6, I could get it.
But guess what?
I could get it.
I disagree. You've been in the game for a minute, so you know what you're signing up for. So if you're going to marry somebody that's an actor, you know what's you know
well,
what comes with the
well, she was definitely not an actor. Law school. No, I mean, medical school.
No, but you are. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So she knows that you're going to be on.
I know,
on
but yeah, I think back. I could have invited her. I could have. You know,
okay.
I could have did things.
But she also didn't have to have a baby on
well,
it.
Well, hey, if you met somebody and
how'd it, you find out?
A baby!
No, but like, so wait, the baby.
I don't want to talk about that no more because I don't want I ain't putting my if we're friends and everything's beautiful
okay,
and
fair enough.
Yeah, yeah. I ain't trying to put that out there.
I got you.
I know I have to pay most of my money.
I want to rewind to Juwanna Mann.
Okay.
I was watching that the other day.
All right.
And I always wonder, as a man and as a straight man, what was it like to have a role where you had to dress up as a woman?
It's easy if you are doing that role like Robin Williams did it to be a maid.
Okay.
It's easy to do it if you're doing that role to get a woman.
Okay.
I was trying to get that woman to get Vivica Fox.
You were.
Because I was trying to keep my career going. It's a lot easier to do that than to be doing it for, you know, even, it doesn't matter to me. If I were to play like a, what's this, all of this talk going on about transgender and trend, if I were to play like a dramatic role like that, I'd get an Oscar. I would get an Oscar because I know there's so much pain for him. And everybody asks me, what do you feel about that? And what do you feel about that? I know you're a Christian, and you're a Christian, and you're a Christian, and I know how you feel about that. I'm dying to know how you feel about it. And I'd say the same thing to you I say to everybody. I look straight 100% to the Bible, to the Word of God, for how I'm supposed to respond to that and to that whole thing. And the Bible is very clear. The Bible says, and I will give anybody $100,000 cash if you show me anywhere in the Bible where it says, love thy straight neighbor as thyself.
Right, right.
The Bible says, love thy neighbor as thyself. Right. So if your neighbor's gay, straight, transgender, I don't care what he is, the Bible says you to love them as you would yourself. And it also says, judge not that ye may not be judged also.
Right.
So just love everybody and don't judge people. If we just live by that, it'd be utopia.
Right.
If everybody just loved and not judged, it's real. So the Bible's clear. Don't try to use the Bible to say anything else. Right. You say, they're not going to go to heaven. If a thief and a murderer could go to heaven, so can anybody else.
That's right. Right.
Period. And I'll prove it to you. When Jesus was on the cross, there was a thief and a murderer next to him. Now, he could have murdered 742,000 people and ate them. He could have stole everything in a man's house. For the last 30 years. And one of them said to Jesus, yeah, if you really the Son of God, why don't you call your angels down here and have them take you off? The other one, who was a murderer or a thief, whichever, he said, remember me when you get to your father's house. Your father, meaning I believe you were the son. He not once said, forgive me for anything. And Jesus said, because of your faith, there you will be also. Just Jesus died for your sins, all of our sins, not the sins you commit. He died for the sins you committed, the sins you're committing now, and the ones you will commit. There is no more sin. The only thing it takes to get to heaven is you have to believe that he is the Son of God. That's the only way you get that to experience the forgiveness that he gives you from acceptance, period. That man, he didn't ask for nothing. He went to heaven. He could have murdered 300,000 people. He didn't even say, forgive me. He just believed he is the Son of God. Believe Jesus is the Son of God and you are saved, period. So stop judging everybody by what you think and what you believe and love everybody and treat them the same way you want. Imagine if we all just love it. And the same way you want them to be, I could be around anybody. I mean, my ex, we would go downtown and I'd be hugging homeless people. And she'd say, oh my God, you hugging them like they normal people.
What a concept.
If you just do it, this world would be such a better place. And that's how I live. Period. I don't care who you are, what you are, what you got, how much you got, how much you don't have. It doesn't matter. I came here homeless. I lived in the street downtown L.A. I landed downtown L.A. I slept behind a bus station. I woke up every day with lice on me every day, eating out of the trash. And I'd look at every single day as a blessing.
Yes, period. Miguel. On that note, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back.
Yes, let's take a look at what she did to my toe. Look what she hooking it up.
Y'all give it up. Give it up.
Kiss it.
Crafted in the heart of San Francisco over 25 years ago and inspired by the city's daring nature, the highly awarded Junipero Gin boldly challenges the norms of a vodka-dominated market to lead the American craft gin revolution.
Welcome back to Pedis and Mimosas Live. We have Pretty Ricky in the building. What's up?
I'm pretty wicked, why they call me?
Look, I'm a diehard Martin fan, diehard. What was that era like?
Oh, that was so much fun.
I can imagine.
And then Martin called me right after and gave me Reggie the Chicken King. And what was it? What's the name of that movie? Thin Line Between Love and Hate. Yeah. So just walked in and killed that shit. And it was so much fun on the set because that was the first season.
Yeah.
And it was like 100% less tension. So everybody was laughing and joking, having a good time.
Yeah, and that was such an iconic role, and it was just like a moment. That's dope. Do people call you Pretty Ricky in the streets?
No, all the time. Hey, I didn't know that group, Pretty Ricky, that's why they named their group.
Shut up.
I swear, I did not know that. I was at some concert. They were opening for some concert, and I'm sitting down in the front row, and they said, and they jumped off stage and ran down, and their father came running out, and they literally announced that's how they saw the show, and that's why their name in the group is called Pretty Ricky from that character.
That's crazy.
And they're saying that's the first selfie, too.
Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Dropping gems on me today.
Because I, you know, I walked out, took a picture of myself. I remember asking. I was like, would it be stupid if I took a picture of myself? And I remember asking that question. I did it anyway.
That's awesome. So being in the game as long as you have, like, what is, I asked Elise Neal this. She was on the show. What's the source?
What's like, the source of what?
What's the formula?
The formula for being in the business, like, my first TV show was 19. Nah, nigga. My first TV show was 19. All right, brother. Was 1987. Tour of Duty.
I was like.
Exactly.
Oh, I wasn't born yet.
Yeah. It was called Tour of Duty. It was a Vietnam show on CBS and it was a big hit. Mm-hmm. It was called Tour of Duty. As a matter of fact, it's still like in the top 10, even to this day in Europe, yeah. All over Europe. And in fact, you can watch it on one of the channels. It was about a platoon in Vietnam. Mm-hmm. It was on for 3 years, CBS, the top 10 show.
Thank you. That's awesome. How have you seen like the industry change?
Ah, sorry, right? I forgot the first question because she kind of hit that toe. what was the first question?
Oh, what was the first question? Because I'm a little...
All right, well, go ahead to the second one.
I'm a little lit, too.
Me too, girl.
Being in the industry as long as you have, like, what are some of the similar...
Damn, that's good, brother.
Gosh.
That is really... What is this?
Soleil mimosas.
No, I'm saying, is it like you have to mix this or...
Ready to drink. No,
I'm oh, you got some of this?
That too. Yes.
Oh, I want to hook this. It is good. Wow. You want a sip? No. All right, go ahead. Ask your question. Sorry.
Being in the game as long as you've been in the game, what are some of the similarities and differences that you've seen from 1987 until now?
The difference?
And then I asked you about longevity.
It is. Oh, that was the question.
Yeah.
That's the better question. I think that it's to just do good work every single time. Don't worry about how small it is. I've gotten a TV series from one scene in a movie.
Really?
I've gotten a movie from one scene in a TV show. Mm. Everything you do, go in there and knock it out the park every time. Just do the best job you can do. And when you get on the set, just always knock it out. Because these people go from set to set to set to set, yeah. To set to set to set. The crew, they go, and they talk and they talk. You go in an attitude and shit and thinking you, they're going to go right around. It's going to spread. So always just do the best job. I've always got along with everybody. I usually hang out with crew and just have a good time. And I'm always like to laugh. I don't like to judge. I always had my own, even when I was homeless and I was doing shit when I was homeless. Friday 13th, my first job, I was still homeless. Let me just give you this little tidbit. Jumping Jack Flash. Have you ever seen that?
No.
You've never seen Jumping Jack Flash?
Yo, people always be like, you ain't seen nothing. I am not a big, I seen Juwanna Mann. With Whoopi Goldberg.
Yeah, okay, well, next time, okay, here you go. Well, watch Jumping, you know of it, that's good enough. Jumping Jack Flash, when they did Jumping Jack Flash, I was homeless on the street downtown Atlanta. When I was, hey, she got some too, look. Crocs. We did, I got ADD. We did,
all good.
They were shooting Jumping Jack Flash, I was homeless downtown LA. When I graduated from school now, I was 4'11". And weighed 75 pounds.
Tell me this was like second grade.
When I graduated.
Tell me this was second grade, though.
When I graduated from high school.
You was 4'11".
4'11 and weighed 75. I was less, I 75 pounds. I was 50 pounds until the ninth grade. That's why I'm still skinny. So.
But you're like mad tall. Like,
I grew up in one summer. I skyrocketed. You know why black people are taller?
Why?
Because they're Negroes.
Shut up! Somebody come get him. Come get this guy.
No, but...
Oh, man.
No, but that's true. And I'll prove it to you. I haven't grown that far yet, so... If you watch Jumpin' Jack Flash, when they were shooting Jumpin' Jack Flash, I was homeless. I would go because they had all that, you know how the movie have all that food, mm-hmm. And I would be stealing food off of their trucks. And they would go, shoot, get out of here. Joel Silver, who mm-hmm. I ended up doing, gave me Lethal Weapon Flash, Lethal Weapon 3, which I was in, Action Jackson, which I started in. He ended up giving me all of those. He was like, hey, leave him alone. Come here. And I was told 1,000 people this. My name is Miguel Nuñez. I talked like this when I first got here, because I'm from North Carolina. I said, my name is Miguel Nuñez. I'm from Wilson, North Carolina, 647 3rd Street. I came here to be an actor. I said that everywhere I went. He was like, all right, leave him alone. Let him eat. So he let me eat. The next time you're watching, he said, you know what? I'm going to put him in this next scene. The next time you're watching Jumpin' Jack Flash, when Whoopi Goldberg gets dressed to go out, and she's dressed up walking down the sidewalk, he goes, and go. You're going to see the skinniest looking, homeless looking crack here with a big head and about that big. And that was me. Watch.
Oh, my God.
And you're going to see, and if you ever see, and this is like something your grandmothers and them used to watch. Archie Bunker.
Uh-huh.
He put me in their scene.
Archie,
the little girl was running away from home in a bus station. That was me sitting right next to him and the little girl.
Wow.
He kept putting me in all of this stuff.
And you didn't lose hope while you was homeless?
Never lose hope. Never. Every single person, when I ran away from home, every single person in my entire life said the same thing. You're skinny, you're black, you're poor, and you're ugly. It's not possible.
Yeah.
You're deep in the country on a farm. There's no way. There's actors in New York, Chicago, Philadelphia, Atlanta. They got agents, they got managers in college, they got degrees. How in the hell is your skinny, poor black ass going to get in front of them?
Right.
Even my mama, everybody. It's not even possible. You make straight A's and B's. You can do anything you want. You got to just figure it out. Yeah. Don't try to go to this. And I was told, when I got to first grade, I had a jean jacket. I took a magic marker and wrote Hollywood on the back of it.
Wow.
I told everybody to listen every single day exactly. I promise you, as soon as I graduate, I'm going to run away to Hollywood. I don't want to be a movie star. I told every single person that would ever listen every single day. Never let anybody tell you what you are capable of doing or not doing. Period. If you have a passion for it, just go for it.
Yes, I love it. I love to hear it. I'm all about it. How long were you homeless for?
Shit. Probably about 8 months.
That's
and then
long
I went to the
time.
Union. I ended up going to the Union Rescue Mission. I was sleeping on the park bench, and like I said, everybody thought I was a little kid. And I was sleeping on the park bench. The guy said, "What are you out here for?" Now, my name is Miguel Nuñez. I'm 6'4", 7'3". I came here. Wasn't over. He was like, "I couldn't." Why? Everybody would go. They didn't believe me.
Yeah.
So he ended up telling me about the Union. If you go to the Union Rescue Mission, I don't know if they still have it because I've been there a while. They used to have a big picture of me there. People who have gone through the Union Rescue Mission and gone on to do things. Some people in city council or something. But there was a picture of me in the Union Rescue Mission. But it's not the big $2 million facility that mm-hmm. they're in now.
Mm-hmm,
it was a little shitty little hole in the wall, which was just a church. And it had pews. And then when you wake up, if you got in there before 7, and they called me young blood, because back then in the 80s, there were nobody, young people like in their families now. But I was like the youngest person there. And I'd be sitting in the couch, and you wake up in the morning, there's bombs on you this way and that way. And you wake up and just scratching and scratching.
Miguel.
Then you go downstairs, you have to take your clothes off. And they spray you with poison and wash your clothes. And I just
spray you with poison.
No, they did. They took us in a room, and the guy would take one of a little silver thing where you push the pump down.
Yeah.
And he's got on a mask. And he was like, shh, and they spray you.
Oh my God. 8 months.
Well, wow. Then I ended up going to Union Rescue Mission. And then I ended up going to getting on welfare. And they gave me a job at Rancho Los Amigos Hospital in Downey, California, under the physical therapy technician. Mm-hmm. And one day I'm on a bus, I'm gonna skip all that shit. This is how I really got started. I was on a bus one day, and this guy going. And I was like, what are you doing? He said, I'm an actor. I said, my name is Miguel Nuñez, 647 3rd Street. I was like, what are you doing? He was like, I'm going to this, it's a cattle call. It's a cattle call for a commercial. They're doing a commercial called Gino's Restaurant, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, okay. And he was like, what's that? He said, it's a resume. I said, can I see? He said, yeah, here, keep that. You're going to need to get a resume. You have to get pictures, you get an agent, blah, 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 blah. And I see him get off, and I see him go into a park. And I see cameras. So I ended up getting off at the next stop or two. And I went to a copy place and I wiped his name. I put my name out. I went back and got in line. I got the lead in that commercial.
Oh my God.
Never done anything. I took that and I was like, and the guy was like, hey, you got an agent? I was like, no. And the guy was like, hey, I was like, that's him. He took me to his agent. His agent signed me. And I think the next 47 auditions he sent me on, I probably got 42 of them.
Wow. Yeah. What a story.
Oh, that's the fast version, though.
Oh, my God. Because
I used to sell my blood
stuff.
Plasma to eat. Used to go to the Height Regency Wish a Well and steal money.
Like,
when you're stealing, you know, you can't go like this because coins going to move in water. So you got to sit there and kind of move them, get them in a pile first.
You know.
The art of stealing. You got to get them all in a pile first.
Yeah. They don't give enough money when you give blood. Huh? I consider no. that.
But dude, when I did it, it was $14.
14 whole dollars for your good
blood. No, $7. If you did it twice in the same week, you got $14 the second time.
That's ridiculous. No, I think it's only like $40
chicken,
now.
I still got a fries and a chicken fries and a Coke from churches. I had never had churches. We didn't have no. Oh my God, nigga, every morning. I was so hungry.
You have a story. Oh. I never even knew all that.
And my mother is the writer of It's a Man's World, James Brown's biggest hit. That's my mother. My mother.
Really?
Yes.
Oh my God. Give it up for Mama Nuñez.
Yeah.
All right now. So.
Girl, you rubbing that foot like you into this shit. What's your number?
Scott. We gotta take a break. We'll be right back with more of Miguel Nuñez, y'all. Pedis and Mimosas live. Let's go. Pedis Mimosas Live. I'm sitting here with the amazing, hilarious, I should say, Miguel Nuñez. Miguel, we have to do a toast.
Yes, whatever you want to do a toast to.
We are toasting.
Listen to me, I'm going to say this first.
Yes.
I'm shocked. My feet really do look good.
Of course. You're going to come to Pedis Mimosas and not have a good drink and not have a good pedi.
No, but I thought it was just going to be like, you know, some fake
pedicure. Like something fake.
Yeah, yeah. While we talk, they go down there and do that fake. Mm-mm. No, she really hooked my feet up. My feet ain't look this good
in a while. Real deal. It's the real deal, sir.
Damn. All right. I'm very impressed.
So I want to toast to your...
I got a tip. Don't eat yellow snow.
Don't eat yellow snow. Did y'all get it? Anyway, I want to toast to you, your amazing energy.
He's a little distracted.
Sorry, go ahead.
Wait, real quick. Would you rather do like comedic acting or what's the other one?
Drama.
Drama.
It doesn't matter because either one. I've done both. I mean, I got nominated for Tour Duty was a drama.
Mm-hmm.
And Sparks was a comedy.
Yeah.
But it doesn't matter. I can take the same lines and make you laugh and not even change the lines, change the delivery and make you cry.
Yeah.
I can take a dramatic scene, can be as dramatic as fucking, I can bring a joke in and make you just, hey, why are you tearing up? Just laugh and then go back to crying if I want. It doesn't matter to me.
Yeah.
I like them both. Comedy is harder.
I've always heard that.
It is harder.
Yeah. I assumed it at first because that's like your natural personality, that it would be easy for you to pull off, you know.
No, for me it is. Yeah, it is. Yeah, yeah. But for other people who not like don't have it as, you know, you're saying, tuned up.
Right, right.
It's harder because it's hard to comedy is really there's a rhythm. I'll give you an example. There's a rhythm to comedy. And a lot of actors, because I teach privately, a lot of actors come to me and say, How do I make this part funny? And then they go to audition and go, I was great. They rolling, they were laughing and I didn't get it. I don't get it. Mm-hmm. They were laughing, of course. Of course they are. There's a rhythm and a flow to comedy. There's two shows I was on. Sparks was one of them, where the producer explicitly said, nobody else can ad-lib but Miguel Nuñez. If you do it again, you're fucking fired.
Wow.
And that's most of the show. You have to know how to do it and get on the line. I just did a movie with some girl. Every time I came on a great kappa, she would go, oh, yeah. I said, stop, cut. Please don't feel like you got to add something every time. She fucking, that was a scene where this zombie was coming at us.
Mm-hmm.
And my girl was standing next to me, right? And the zombie, I said, listen, hey. And he's standing, he started coming. I said, hey. He kept coming. I said, you better step back, bitch. My girl stepped back. I said, no, not you.
Yo, you stupid as hell. I swear to God.
That wasn't in there. That wasn't in there. The only beat was, yeah, no, then I did that. But I figured that if you can find something that stays in the flow, and most people can't do that. Yeah. My friend goes, how do I make this funny? Okay, you have to remember your place in that particular scene. Mm-hmm. And I was saying, sometimes in comedy, you ain't supposed to be funny. Mm-hmm. That's why they were laughing, because the flow is like this. Yeah. In this scene, you're this person. And the next line is, knocks the joke out of the park. Mm-hmm. And now you and they're going, and you done f***ed up the flow because you're trying to make your shit funny. Right. And now you done f***ed up this, and he done swung and missed because you done f***ed up this flow. Mm-hmm. And the writers and the producers sitting there going, we ain't looking for somebody to do jokes. We're looking for somebody who can follow the flow of because that's how the show is going to be written, in a flow and a comedy.
Like understanding the essence of it.
I like when you be getting that shit, girl.
Okay.
Are you going to kiss this one, too?
Look at them dogs. Look at them dogs. I see you, Miguel.
Yeah, I like the way she rubbed them. Look at her. She's going like this. I like the way she biting her bottom lip every time she rubs them.
You're so stupid. I want to play a game with you.
Okay, good. When?
So this, right now.
Oh, right now.
When? So I want to play a game with you.
All right.
We got a game called Petty or Mimosa.
Shit. Please don't do that spot either.
Petty or Mimosa is a game that I made up.
Okay.
So there's a bunch of questions in that bowl right there where you got the chocolates.
You done f***ed everything up.
Pull a question.
Okay.
You're going to read it out loud. Okay. The question might be petty or it may require a petty response.
Okay.
If you don't want to participate in our pettiness, you got to take a slurp shot.
Okay.
Okay?
All right.
Take it away. Time for a game of Petty or Mimosa.
Why did she pull on your bundle? If you could bring back one of... Who would it be, Bernie Mac or Red Fox? Bernie Mac, and let me tell you something. Here's some of the things you guys don't know about Bernie Mac. Bernie Mac was one of the nicest guys. He was one of those Hollywood nice guys. We would go to movies. I've done a lot of stuff with Bernie, not just life. And Bernie, every time we go out, we're going to do this, we're going to do that. Hey, dude, listen, we're at the hotel, dude, listen. We got like 20 girls coming by. Nope.
I'm not into that. I'm a married man.
Wow.
He would go home. Bernie Mac didn't play anything. My family, I'm this.
And I love it.
He was really 100% that way. Straight up family man. Always honest. Always the nicest guy you will ever meet in your life. 100% yeah. Bernie.
Awesome.
So, I bring them both back, you know, real sample, but yeah, Bernie.
So you're not taking a slurp shot this time, but we might get you on the next question.
No, you won't, but go ahead.
Miguel.
What? I'm sorry.
You munching on that funky chunky is good, right?
This is good.
Yep.
You know these people?
Yep.
Funky chunky, send me some shit.
Okay. Okay.
The way you working that toe, girl, you working that toe.
So we're going to continue playing Petty or Mimosa. You got another question in there.
Hold on, let me get one more.
Yeah, munch on it, munch on it. Get it.
It's really good, though, for real. I'm not kidding. Okay, that's another one?
Yeah.
Okay. If you could ride the host or your pedicurist, who would it be?
What did I say?
If you could ride the host or the...
Who made this question up? What?
I don't think that's the real question.
Oh, wait, let me turn it over. Sorry.
I actually fell for that. Oh, my God. I fell for that. I'm like, wait, who made up that question?
I'm sorry, it was upside down. Martin Lawrence, Eddie Murphy. Eddie Murphy is the reason because Eddie Murphy is classic. Eddie Murphy played 5 motherfuckers in 1 movie. The Mamba, the Grandma. How can Eddie Murphy not have an Oscar?
But Martin did 8 in his show.
Man, 8? No. Martin. I'm not taking nothing from either one of them.
Yeah.
But I think Eddie's here and Martin is here, and I think Martin would even say that. 100%. Martin would say that.
I mean,
Martin
I guess so.
Would say that.
Maybe because I'm a diehard Martin fan.
Yeah, me too. I watch Martin every day, all day, every day, and I've seen the same ones. I laugh at the same joke.
Me
the
too.
The same bitch every single
Who's
time.
Who's your favorite character of Martin?
Martin! What are you talking about? I like the mom. I like Shanae. I like the. I say Jerome in the house.
Yes,
I say Jerome in the house. Shut your mouth. Eat that tongue, girl.
Listen, so you picking Eddie Murphy?
Actually, because Eddie is the GOAT, you know.
Yeah, for sure.
In our generation. And I think Martin would say that as well. As a matter of fact, I think he said it a couple of times.
Yeah. So we got, maybe we'll get you with the next one. One last one.
I never lose. Oh, shit.
Read it. What is that?
White girl with a big booty or black girl with no ass? White girl with a big booty or black girl with no ass? That's a tough one. That's not the question.
But wait, no, get into that though.
No, I knew you were going to say that. Wait, what did I say?
White girl with a big booty, black girl with no booty. That's what you said, right?
A black girl with no booty is should be a sin. It should be a sin.
Every black girl is not blessed with a big booty.
Have you ever seen a black girl with a flat ass?
I don't got a booty.
It's impossible. It's impossible. You sitting on something. Hold on, look. This one's safe. This is a good one. Harlem Nights are life. I'm going to have to go with life.
Okay.
I was in both.
Yeah.
But life, you had the same amount of stars. I mean, you had, in Harlem Nights, you had Richard Pryor, you had Rick James, we had so many people. It was just so, it was magical.
Yeah.
It was magical. And that whole speech I gave about going home at the end, none of that shit was in the script.
Straight improv?
You remember when you ate your cornbread, when they cut to that scene, he just turned around and he faded out.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
That's how they were doing all of us. Mm. All you saw was they cut to everybody dancing, and you saw me running across the gun line, and that was it. They were gonna kill each one of us like that. So I went to the director. I'm like, wait, whoa. What the is this? They're gonna kill me today? He goes, Miguel, what are you talking about? I said, well, no, you gotta have a reason. He said, I'm not a writer. What do you mean you gotta have a reason? He said, Miguel, that's something you should have told me a long time ago so we can get the writers on it. I was like, but the people are going to want to know why he ran across the line. He said, Miguel, I don't know. He said, I'll tell you what. Let's go. Bring the cameras. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Roll. Tell us why he did it. And Eddie said, come on, shit. And I was like, okay. And all of that entire speech was made up right there on the spot. And Eddie just rolled with it. Man, what you talking about? Your mama going to. And I pulled that my letter from home. That was a call sheet.
Oh, my God.
None of that shit was in there.
That's dope.
One take.
That's super dope.
Following
yeah.
the flow.
Yeah. Yeah, I like that they gave you freedom
yeah,
to
oh,
do
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
Because they know that you to go on that.
Yeah, the director was
good. That's what's
cool. Up. Was that life? Yeah, up until that point, till I had to knock his ass out.
Yeah. You've had a lot of great moments in, you know, your career, but what about the not so great moments? I know that there has had to have been one.
The not so great moment, the absolute not so greatest moments of my entire career has happened in the last 4 years, which I can't talk about. I'm like, Chris, I'm still on the show. I ain't gonna say nothing about it. At the time, proper time, I will talk about it. It will be serious and it won't be funny. That's all I have to say.
Okay. Well, you kinda heard it here first, damn it.
You damn sure did, I swear to God.
Cause I know Hollywood is a mess.
It is, but you know, you just keep your nose clean. You don't worry about Hollywood. You
right.
just keep going your path.
Right.
You keep living right, doing the right, doing right. the right thing. Anything, all of that will bounce off you like duck off a water bag.
Right.
If you don't, I've been to, you know, Hollywood a long time. I've seen all of that shit going on all around me. But as long as I keep my path, I'm doing what I'm supposed to do, stay in your lane, do what you're supposed to do.
Right.
I can listen to it, I can hear to it. Don't try to get involved. You try to jump all into it and stay your ass out of it, stay in your lane, keep your faith. None of that stuff will affect you.
I hear you. We'll be right back.
Keep it locked, y'all. After this message from Toad. We'll be right back.
to Pedis and Mimosas Live. I am sitting here chatting with one of the greats, Miguelito.
¿Cómo está?
So, ¿cómo está? Hola, ¿cómo está?
Well, she mad because she had to leave.
Bien, ¿y tú?
Yeah, you had to get some help, huh? Yeah.
So tell us about family business. What's going on with that?
Oh, well, we're in our fourth season. We, as a matter of fact, last day is this coming Saturday. We just finished fourth season. And right now you can watch third season on BET on Tuesdays and on Saturdays, both running both. They're showing third season. As a matter of fact, I think fourth season just started, sorry. Fourth season just started on BET and BET Plus.
Nice, nice.
And fourth season is going to be fire because I can't tell you.
Okay.
I do. There's something I do in this last season that's freaking serious.
I respect it. I respect it. So you got anything else going on that you want to share with everybody?
I'm going to be producing and doing another series in Atlanta coming up in May, and it's another drama. It's a really powerful series called Cocaine Sisters, and it's about some, you know, just straight up a millennial freaking sisters out there doing their thing, DJ, running the club, and they're also dealers and the high game stakes of all of that, and it's really powerful. We're going to be shooting in Atlanta
for
about 3 or 4 months. I'm going to be going to Tunisia.
Ooh, Tunisia.
Yeah, a friend of mine, he owns a big studio over there. But I don't know if you guys know that in Ghana, did you know in Ghana? I'm going to be visiting Ghana as well because in Ghana, if you're African-American, so you don't have to live over here in poverty. That's where Stevie Wonder's moving. If you're African-American in Ghana, you automatically assist a citizen the moment you land foot there.
I think I did hear that.
And you also get free land.
What?
You didn't hear that, of course, yes.
Definitely not.
And not just regular free land. You get real free land. So you ain't got no shit here, go over there, and you get free land.
Seriously?
Oh, yes. And Ghana is opulently beautiful.
I can imagine.
That's why Stevie went.
You got to take me with you.
Shit, I can take you to Ghana tonight, girl.
Yo, I cannot with you.
You wake up in the morning going, woo, Lord, I saw deer, reindeer, and giraffes.
Dear? Miguel, let's do a toast, please.
I love you, and I love your show.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
My pleasure.
For being here. I did the last.
You got to invite me back.
I will. Okay. You got to come.
Oh, God.
You promise?
Shit, it's on you. You make me come, I come.
This guy.
You make me come, I make you come.
I cannot.
Oh, yeah, you mean come back to the show? Oh, yes. Yeah, of course.
Since I did the last toast, you do the toast.
Okay, hi. I would like to propose a toast to you and to the amazing crew and everybody that you guys are working with, that you guys have put together an amazing, amazing production.
Thank you.
And I wish you all the success and anything and everything I can do to help you, I'm there for you.
I'm going to hold you to that.
Please do. You can hold out me out too.
Cheers. Cheers. And that's a wrap, y'all.
And that's a wrap, y'all.
Tune in next week to another episode of Pedis and Mimosas Live. Thank you for being my guest. Peace out, y'all. West B, take us out.